Hi, I'm Lisa Natoli with the Teachers of God Foundation, teachersofgod.org, and today I'm going to be answering a question that came into us about how does A Course in Miracles look at dealing with violence and the state of this world? And I love this question because so often we want to take it from the lofty ideas back into the practical application. How can we show up? What can we do? And so I thank you for joining me. And what we're doing here at the Teachers of God Foundation now is we're answering questions on these weekly blogs. So if you have a question you would like to see us answer, you can just write it in. There's a box on the sidebar, and we just love to hear from you. And this one comes from Shivani Ma, and she writes, "Hi Lisa, I'm wondering what is A Course in Miracles' take on things like the Florida shooting? Can you address this in a talk? Love to you. I love you, Shivani Ma." And I love this question. And we are seeing a lot of violence in the world right now. Just people with guns walking into schools and banks and businesses and killing people. And what often happens in situations like this is an immediate feeling of shock and then fear and helplessness. We feel powerless to change anything. And what does A Course in Miracles say about this? So today I'm going to give you 3 steps for things that you can do. And the first step comes from my dear friend Vicki Thomas, and I love this one. It's stop, drop, and pray. And that's what I do. Whenever I see or hear anything in the news about this violence, a shooting, a rape, someone is being killed, I stop, drop, and pray. And I bring myself into the quiet place and I remember the truth. And my immediate reaction every time is shock. I feel the shock when I hear these stories to this day. And then I immediately just stop, drop, and pray. And I come into a place of quietness. I remember my husband, Bill Free, months ago, there was another shooting, and he'd seen a lot of posts on Facebook, and he said to me, "What happened?" I said, "Oh, some guy walked into a school, and, you know, 10 or 20 people were shot and killed." And Bill got really quiet. And later he told me his practice was just to go into the quiet place and start blessing, really just remembering the truth. If you're here watching this video, chances are you know A Course in Miracles. It says all minds are joined, and what we do in our mind ripples through every mind. And so now you can use your mind to heal and to bless and to send light and to send love. And one of the things that often happens is we start judging. The mind goes into fear and we start judging the person. We start trying to find a worldly solution. And I love Jesus as a teacher and the best demonstration for me of being up there on the cross. And he said, "Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do." And anybody who shoots another person, walks into a school and starts shooting, they don't know what they're doing and they don't know who they are. So they need compassion, not judgment. And so that's the first thing. Stop, drop, and pray. Enter into the quiet space. Remember the truth. Remember that you can send out light. You can send out this feeling of love. And I love that. And the second thing is to know that you're a miracle worker. And often we don't think of ourselves as miracle workers. We don't know that we can do something in that situation. And so this is a real radical shift in perception when you start seeing yourself in a new light and you start recognizing that I can help. And there's so many stories, and science is even backing it up now, that there is a frequency, a vibration that goes out that affects everyone and everything. And now you can take part of that. And you start sending light and love to the families, to those who have passed. You just bring yourself into that place and say, "This is my work to do. Like, this is what I'm here to do." And you take your part as a healer. And you use every situation now simply to bless. Jesus in A Course in Miracles says, as a miracle worker, your job is only to bless. And so you catch now these places where you're judging, where you're worrying, where you're in fear. And you just shift right over and just say, no, this is the work I'm here to do. I'm here to be a light in the dark. I'm not here to join the chaos. I'm not here to be part of the problem. I'm here as a solution. And the third thing I love is right here. I have a little saying here, listen, follow, and trust. And this is a teaching that I've been giving for a very long time. This was a teaching I gave in Denmark, and somebody made this for me, my dear friend Joan. And I just keep it nearby because listen, follow, and trust is a practice where you're listening within to the voice that tells you what to do. And so in this moment, when you hear violence, you see violence, you're entering into the quiet space, you know you're a miracle worker, and then you're listening. And what Jesus tells us in A Course in Miracles is to ask within, what would you have me do? What would you have me say? Where would you have me go? So you're acknowledging that you're not alone, that there's a guide and a teacher and a presence and a power with you. And now you're listening. And you will be guided. Sometimes it's just to bless and remember the truth. Other times it's to actually get up and go do something. And Jesus says, I need your hands, I need your eyes, I need your feet, I need most of all your willingness to be available to serve. I love what those kids in Florida did. You know, they just said enough and they got up and they moved. They followed through with action. And when you're listening and you're following and you're trusting, you're in the flow. And that's all we can do. We're part of the solution now. And so what I ask for you is to really look at what's your fear. What happens when you see and hear these stories of violence? Look at your fear, because the training of A Course in Miracles is to find the blocks and the obstacles to the awareness of love's presence. You're going from fear to love. So what do you fear? And what I ask for you to do is write it in the comments below. And what are you going to do about it? This is a shift. You're recognizing the fear and you're shifting. And I just want to say thousands of people come through this website every single week. So I ask you to post as much detail as you can in the comment area of what do you do as a miracle working principle? What's your practice? I'd love to hear from you. And there's so many people that read these comments. They come through this website. They don't post, but they read the comments. And so when you post there, you're really sharing the solution. And I just give thanks for you for being here, for showing up the way you do, and for just extending the light and the love and the truth of God that you are. So it is a time for all of us to join together in one purpose and not be part of the problem anymore, but to be the light in the darkness. And that's why we're here. We're here to remember this. So I thank you for watching. If you like this video and this message, please share it with your friends. If you have a question, please send it to us. And again, most of all, please post in the comments below your miracle working techniques. Thank you so much. I love you.